policy change we have come to present to you today regards the federal minimum wage. We propose that Congress raise the federal minimum wage to $10.50 on the 3rd of July, 2017. Congress will do this gradually over the course of 3 years in order to give businesses time to adjust to the changes. We propose the minimum wage change because A, it lowers the rate businesses replace their workforce, which is known as the turnover rate and how it will be referred to as hereafter. B, it will give the economy and the working class families a much needed boost. And C, the minimum wage is not kept up with inflation or the rising cost of education and health care. This issue is an important one because the federal minimum wage has been at $7.25 since the 24th of July in 2009. 8 years have passed since then and the wage is still not changed. The minimum wage is more than due for renegotiation. By raising the minimum wage to $10.50 an hour, the American people will be better equipped to deal with the issues mentioned, which I will now go into further detail with one by one. A, raising the minimum wage will reduce business turnover rate, increasing job security. According to a report prepared for the Seattle Income Inequality Advisory Committee, written by Michael Reich, Ken Jacobs, Annette Bernhardt, increased labor costs can be absorbed through a variety of other channels, including savings from reduced worker turnover and improved efficiency, higher prices and lower profits. In other words, in order to keep up with increased productivity, employers will be able to bring more people into the workforce, as well as increasing the pool of reliable workers, which reduces turnover rates and increases employment. This brings me to my next point, B. Raising the minimum wage will give the economy and working class families a much needed boost. When I mentioned increased employment due to increased productivity earlier, I meant that businesses are essentially forced to hire more workers because more people are going to spend their money on them. According to a report for the Economic Policy Institute by David Cooper and Douglas Hall, raising the minimum wage would help reverse the ongoing erosion of wages that has contributed significantly to growing income inequality. At the same time, it will provide a modest stimulus to the entire economy, as increased wages would lead to increased consumer spending, which would contribute to GDP growth and modest employment gains. Raising the minimum wage gives middle class people more spending power, which is the root of any strong economy. And finally, C, the minimum wage has not kept up with inflation or the rising costs of education and health care. At this point, it is basically a necessity that the minimum wage be raised. A college education is becoming harder and harder to acquire in the United States due to the high cost of tuition. Many states are cutting funding for higher education, which means that the tuition rates and fees will continue to rise. During the time after the Second World War, college used to cost around $35,000, $3,500, adjusted for inflation, and it has risen tremendously since then. Education is still very important today, and it helps create a highly skilled workforce that will make corporations more productive and create more jobs, making America even more competitive in the global market. According to David Leonhard, an editor for the New York Times that focuses on politics, policy, and economics, the pay gap between college graduates and everyone else in the country is near its all-time high. The countries that have done a better job increasing their educational attainment, like Canada and Sweden, have seen bigger broad-based income gains than the United States. To make it easier for students aiming for a higher education, the minimum range of wage must be raised. These students likely also have rent checks to write and groceries to buy on top of paying off their student loan debts. So to recap, the three main reasons we want the minimum wage to change is because it lowers turnout rates, it gives the economy and working class families a boost, and the minimum wage is not kept up with inflation and will help the rising costs of education and healthcare.